compound inequalities, or two directions. When we do have compound inequalities and we have an or, we're going to be going either one or both directions. Meaning going left and right. First, we're going to float each part of the graph above the number line, and then we will combine the union, which is another word for or. The symbol for union is a capital U. So let's take a look at example one. In example one, notice that there are two separate inequalities here. We need to solve them both first. We'll start on the side with our variable, add the opposite to our number. So we get 4x is less than negative 12, divide by 4, and we get x is less than negative 3. Now let's do our other part. I'm going to make sure I bring down my or so that I don't forget it in the end. Again, add the opposite to our number. I have negative 4x is less than or equal to negative 12. Divide by the negative 4. And we get x. Remember to flip our sign because we went and divided by a negative. And we're going to get x is greater than or equal to 3. So now we're going to graph these. So here's my number line. Here's negative 3, and here's 3. We have x is less than negative 3. That means it's going to be an open dot and going to infinity. And then we have x is greater than or equal to 3. That will be a closed dot going to infinity. Okay, now we have going in opposite directions. So our means our graph is going to be open dot at 3, negative 3, to negative infinity, closed dot at 3, to positive infinity. Now for our inequality, we'll write this like this. We're going to go from negative infinity to negative 3. Open dot means we use a parenthesis, union using a capital U, and then we have a closed dot, so we'll use a bracket, 3, comma, to positive infinity, which gets a parenthesis. And so now we have the graph and the inequality. Let's take a look at example two. I'm going to start on the right-hand side. Add the opposite to my variable so I can get my variables on one side. I now have 4x plus 9 is less than negative 19. Add the opposite to my number. And I now have 4x is less than a negative 28. Divide by 4 on both sides. And we get x is less than negative 7. Bring down my or. We're going to distribute here. We're going to get 8x minus 16 less than minus 2 less than or equal to 12x minus 50. Combine my like terms. I have 8x minus 18 less than or equal to 12x minus 50. Let's get our variables on one side, so I'm going to subtract 12x from both sides. Now I have negative 4x minus 18 less than or equal to negative 50. Add 18 to both sides. And now I have negative 4x less than or equal to negative 32. Divide by the negative 4. Again, don't forget to change the direction of your inequality. We get 8 is greater than or equal to, or x is greater than or equal to 8. Now we still have the or. We have x is less than negative 7. So on our graph, we put in our negative 7 and our 8. Negative 7 is going to be an open dot. 8 is going to be a closed dot. We're less than negative 7, so that's going this direction. And x is greater than or equal to 8, so that's going that direction. So our actual graph is going to be an open dot at negative 7, closed dot at 8, and then we're going to infinity, positive and negative on the ends. So now my interval notation is going to be from negative infinity to negative 7 with a parenthesis for the open dot, union, bracket for the 8, comma, infinity, parenthesis for the infinity again.